HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Mesechet Rosh Hashanah, Daf Kafei Amud Aleph, 25A1. But we're going to start on 24B, right? Just a Mishnah. Right? Kav Dalet Amud Bet, just a Mishnah on the bottom. Maaseh Shebaru Shnayim Vamru Reinu Shaharit Bamizrach. There was a story of two witnesses. They came to the Bedin and they said that they saw the old moon. They saw the moon in Shachrit. They saw it Bamizrach, in the east. Okay, Kafei Amud Aleph, 25A1 on the top. The Arvit b'Ma'arav. Now, in the nighttime, they saw it on the west, right? So now the question is, do they believe them? Amar Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri, he says Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri, Edeh Sheker Hem. False witnesses. Why are they false witnesses? Because it's impossible to see the new moon in less than 24 hours, right? Then all of a sudden, it's in two complete, it just doesn't work, right? No. He just said that it's impossible. So Kishabau Liyavne, when they went to Yavne, Kiblu, Kiblan Ram Gamliel. Ram Gamliel accepted them. So why? He accepted the testimony. The old Baush Naim Amru. So there was another story of two people that they came, and they said Rinu Bizmano. They saw it on the 30th, which is Bizmano. Ubelel Iburo. And on the third, the night of the 30th, Lonida, it was not seen. The Kiblan Ram Gamliel. And Ram Gamliel, he accepted it. Right, so you see, Amar Bidosa ben Hurkanus says Bidosa ben Hurkanas. He's trying to get the thing, yeah. Ede sheker hen. He says it's ede sheker, yeah, it's sheker. Hech meidim ala isha shialda al machar kisa ben shimea. He says, how could it be, right, that they're going to come and they're going to testify that a woman gave birth, right? I mean, she already did something, and all of a sudden now she said, no, I didn't do anything. Right, as if I did. Why? I'm still pregnant. I what? She gave birth, right? She already donated something. That's it. She can't say afterwards, no. I'm still pregnant. You're not pregnant. You already did it. You gave it. Yeah? So he says, Amar lo Rabbi Yoshua, says Rabbi Yoshua.
It's like, are you going to do the month or not? If you're going to do it, and then
I have to say,
somebody else
Ani devarecha. He says, it appears to me your words. What does it mean, it appears to me your words? Because he says, it appears to me your words. He says that you're right. These are a du sheker, right? It says that, and therefore we have to be me'abed at the chodesh, meaning that they wanted to come and they wanted to trick the rabbis by trying to make it earlier. So they said, no, these are a du sheker. Forget about it. Don't even bother. Okay? Shalach lo Rabban Gamliel. Rabban Gamliel comes and he sends, right, to Rabbi Yoshua, Gozrani alecha shetavo etzli. I'm going to decree upon you that you're going to come to me, b'makelcha u'mautecha b'yom kippurim. With your makel and with your money, with your staff and your money, on Kippur, it comes out according to your cheshbon. Which means that what's happening is Rabbi Yoshua went and he said that he didn't want to come and he didn't want to accept it. Why didn't he want to accept it? Because he says it's edut sheket, right? However, though, Rabbi Gamliel, he did accept it. So Rabbi Gamliel comes and he says, you know what? He's going to show his authoritative power and he tells him, I want you to come according to your cheshbon on Kippur. I want you to come to me with your pouch, your money pouch, and your makel, carrying. You're not allowed to carry Kippur. Yeah, that's what I want you to do. Right? Alachu mitzao Rabbi Akiva metzeh. So Rabbi Akiva went and he found that Rabbi Yeshua, he was suffering. Right? Why? Because the Nasi, Rabbi Gamliel was a Nasi. The Nasi came and he made a decree. I want you to come to me on this day. Right? Like this. What's he going to do now?
He said that to
who?
Rabbi Gamliel. He said
to Rabbi Yeshua. Okay? So he went and he said, Amarlo, he comes and he says, yeah, he comes and he says like this. Yeah, Amarlo, yesh li limod shekol ma she'asa Rabban Gamliel asui. So he comes and he says like this. Everything, right, which is actually going to be done that Rabbi Gamliel does, is already done. Yeah, she'ne'emar, el le mo'adei Hashem yikrei kol she'tikru otam. Ben mizmanan, ben shelo bizmanan, el li mo'adot elenu. Which means like this. Even though Rabban Gamliel could be 100% incorrect, because according to Rabbi Yeshua, it's 100% incorrect. Even if it's going to be 100% incorrect, it's already chag. It already made the moed. And the fact that it already made the moed, that's it. Yeah, it already made the moed. Okay? So, balo etzel Rabbi Dosa ben Urkanos. So he comes to Rabbi Dosa ben Urkanos. Amarlo, and he comes and he says, im ba'inanu ladun achar bedino shel Rabban Gamliel. If we're going to come and we're going to judge on the bedin of Rabban Gamliel, so we have to actually judge on every single bedin and bedin from the time of Moshe Rabbeinu until now. It says in the pasuk, ויעל משה ואהרון נדב ואביהו ושבעים זקני ישראל. ומשה ורבנו הן אהרון נדב הן אביהו the 70 elders of Israel. ולמה לא נפרשו שמותן של הזקנים? So why didn't we mention the זקנים? Tell me who are the זקנים, right? If people are always looking for kavod and they want that they should be, you know, the only ones and this and that, and they want the kavod, right? Just like what Rabbi Mansur mentioned this morning. No, they need this, they're yearning for it. They're asking for it. They're, you know, they're thirsty for this kavod because to promote themselves. So he says, Ela, so why is it then, right, that we don't come and we don't mention who are the Shivim Zekanim? So he says, Ela lelamed, shekol shlosha u'shlosha shamdu bedina l'Yisrael, hareu kebedino shel Moshe. When you have three people, right, they're like the bedina Moshe Rabbeinu. When you have the bedina, regular bedina, like nowadays, they become like the bedina Moshe Rabbeinu. And therefore, they didn't actually come and they didn't need to mention their names. Natal maklo ma'otav yado, so he went and he took his money and his how do you call it, staff. And he kissed him. And he says, "Boy, v'shalom Rabbi, v'talmidi. Come with me, my rabbi and my talmid. Rabbi bechokhma, v'talmidi shekibalta dvarai." And Rabbi Gamliel came and he gave him a big kavod because of the fact that he came. Which means Rabbi Yeshua at the beginning, he was suffering because Rabbi Yeshua was saying to himself, Ribono Shel Olam, for me it's Kippur. How am I going to go to Rabbi Gamliel with my money and with my staff? But once Rabbi Akiva went and he told them no, that even if they made the mistake, the second that Bedin come and they make it into a month, that's it. Kaddish, there's nothing what to talk about, right? You can't retract. I mean, even if they were wrong, that's the way it is, right? They were wrong. What? Because according to Rabbi Yeshua, he was wrong. They took the wrong day because according to him, it was a bad testimony. So I mean, they had to make it into an extra day and he accepted it to accept the same day. So I mean, basically, according to him, Kippur would have been, according to Rabbi Gamliel, Kippur was the 10th and according to Rabbi Yeshua, it was one day later. Because since you couldn't accept the witnesses, so it's going to be one day later, right? According to Rabbi Yeshua. So the next day after Kippur, when according to Rabbi Yeshua, it's Kippur, he had to come with the money to Rabbi Gamliel. For him, he was suffering like crazy. But then Rabbi Akiva told him, no. That the second that the Bedin make it into the Chag, make it into the month, Kaddish, there's nothing more to talk about. Don't worry about it. So therefore, Rabbi Yeshua went with his money and everything, because he said, I mean, even according to my Cheshbon, it's Kippur, but since the Bedin Shel Mala already paskin like the Bedin Shel Mata, and Bedin Shel Mata was Rabbi Gamliel, that they paskin that this is the month, so then that's it. I don't have to worry. So he went. Rabbi Gamliel came, he kissed him. Okay, says the Gemara. Gemara on Kafei Amud Aleph. Tanya, we learned in a Braita. Amar lahem Rav Gamliel lechachamim. Says Rav Gamliel to the chachamim. Kach mekublani mibet av yaba. This is what I accepted from the house of my forefathers. Pe'amim sheba baruka u'pe'amim sheba bitzara. Which means, right, that sometimes, right, it comes in a long way and sometimes it comes in a short way, right? So, which means that Rav Gamliel says that the way that the month, that the moon travels is not fixed. Sometimes it goes very quick, and sometimes it goes very slow. So, bederech chlal, you're right. The moon will not go so far away from the sun in order to come and to start seeing it until after 24 hours. But sometimes it's very, very quick, and therefore you could actually see it even after 12 hours. So, because of that, that's why Rabbi Gamliel came and he accepted the testimony. Okay, one more time. They said that there was like the old moon and then the new moon, right? You always have to see the new moon. Okay, now between the old moon and the new moon, there's always gonna be a 24-hour period that is empty. You don't see anything. All of a sudden, they saw it within the 24-hour period, right? Because what did he say? He said that they saw it shachrit b'mizrach and arvit b'marav. There was a new moon in the marav. That means it was within the same 24-hour period. So according to Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri, it is sheker. This is sheker. Rabbi Gamliel, he accepted them. So says Rabbi Gamliel, why did I accept them? I have a Kabbalah, I've got a Masoret, a tradition from my forefathers, Mibet Avi Abba. Remember, Gamliel came from David HaMelech, right? They came from, they have the traditions. Gamliel Anasi, you come, you know, Hillel, it's all the Masoret going back up, right? So they went and they say, he said, I have a Masoret, a tradition, that sometimes the moon is not fixed, meaning it doesn't travel at the same speed. Some people, they go very, very quick, and sometimes they go slow. Some people, they're on fire, like when Rabbi Mansur was speaking about in the morning. Yeah, fire, what does that mean? Every single day, every single night, every single shiur. And sometimes they become cold. So it all depends. So the same thing. He says sometimes the moon goes at a regular speed. And sometimes the moon just, boom, it just flies. You understand? So that's what he says. So he says because of that, it was possible that this month it was less than 24 hours. Yochanan, Aman of Yochanan, my tamad divrei Rebbe. What's the reasoning of the Rebbe? Right? Dichtiv, as it says in Pasuk, Asay yareach lemoadim, shemesh yadam evo, which means a person knows the malacha shel ha-shemesh, shemesh would be yadam evo, yareach lo yadam evo. The shemesh is known, because since it's always kavua, meaning the sun is always fixed, the way that it travels. So that's what we know about it. The moon is not always kavua. So since the moon is not always kavua, that's why, according to Rav Gamliel, he said, no, sometimes it could go very quick, and all of a sudden, within a 12-hour period, you can already see the new moon. So therefore, he accepted the testimony. Rav Chiya chazya lesiya rada vekai. Rav Chiya once saw the yareach, siyara is the yareach, right? He says the yareach, the olan, umeb rakiya betzafra, the sim v'tisha, it was in the morning on the 29th of the month. Shakal kala, Rav Chiya went and he took a gush adama, patak bay, and he threw it to the yareach, right? Kilu, that he was throwing it at the moon. So he took a piece of earth and he threw it towards the moon. Obviously, he's not going to hit the moon. You can't hit the moon from throwing it down here. Right? But he kilu was giving him a tochacha. Amar le'orta ba'ina le'kudushevach. He says, tonight, we have to sanctify you. That kaimahacha, and you're just standing here? What are you doing? Zilika said, get out of here. You know, so basically, Rav Chiya comes and he starts telling off the moon, get out of here. Tonight, we want to make you into the Rosh Chodesh, and you're still here? Get out, go away. Yeah? Amar le'Rav Chiya. So says Rebbe to Rav Chiya, Zil le'en tav, right? Go to en tav, v'kad shel yarcha, and make the Kodesh, the moon, make the new month over there. Ushlach li simana, and then send me the siman, right? What? David melech Yisrael chai v'kayam. Right? Why is this a siman? He comes Rebbe, he chose the siman after the Malchut David is compared to the Levana, because it says, v'chiso kashemesh v'negdi ki areach yikon le'olam, which means kaimar reyata levana ba'olam. Okay? So he comes and he says now like this. Tanu Rabbanan, we learned Tanu Braita. Pam achat nikashru shamayim be'avim. It once happened that all of a sudden in the heavens, in the firmament, there was clouds, right? V'nid et demut levana be'esrim v'tisha l'chodesh. And it appeared the image of a moon on the 29th of the month. Kisvurim ha'am lomar rosh chodesh, right? So they thought it was rosh chodesh. U'vikshu bedin l'kadesho. And the Bedin came and they wanted to sanctify it.
Was it the old one or the new one?
Which one?
It was obviously the new moon.
Yes. Right, that's what they thought.
So it was rushed.
Right? It was a new moon. Yeah. So Amala and Gamliel, said the same thing. Kach mekublani mibet avi abba. En chidush yashav na pechudah me'asim v'tisha yom mechzer ushne shlisha v'shvim ushosha chalakim. This is what I told you. Remember that a month is never less than 29 and a half days plus tafshin tzadik gimel. This is 700. Right, that's what it says over here. Right, 2/3 of an hour, the 73 chalakim and 73 chalakim. Okay, so that's what it says over here, right? This is the mahalach of the meaning that it's always minimum that. That day, the mother of Ben Zaza passed away. So Rav Gamliel made a very big eulogy. Not because of that, not because she was fitting for a big eulogy. But rather, so people should know that they didn't be Mekadesh at the Chodesh. Because remember, if it's already Rosh Chodesh, are you allowed to do Rosh, eulogies? You don't do eulogies, you don't do Tacharonim, you don't do eulogies, you don't do, you cut down on everything. And all of a sudden he comes and he's Ma'arich, Ma'arich. Well, what's he taking so long in eulogies? To send a message that they didn't make it into a Rosh Chodesh. Yeah? Fine, two dots. Halach Rebekiva, Matzor Rebekiva. So Rebekiva went and he found Rabbi Yeshua that he was suffering. So he asked the question, was he really suffering? Who was suffering? Rabbi Akiva was suffering or Rabbi Yeshua? Because basically he says, Rabbi Akiva metza. You could read that way in two ways, that Rabbi Akiva found him that he was suffering, or that Rabbi Akiva was found suffering. So who was suffering, Rabbi Akiva or Rabbi Yeshua? So Tashema, we're going to learn from right. At the time we learned from right. So it says, Rabbi Akiva went and he found Rabbi Yeshua when he was metza. Amarlo, so Rabbi Akiva went and he told him, Rabbi, why are you suffering? Amalo, he says, Akiva, Ra'ui lo shipol lamita, shne masar chodesh, right? Vali yigzor lav gzirazo. Do you know that he's fitting to be sick for 12 months on a sick bed and not to have this decree? That means Rabbi Yeshua was so powerful for him, this decree, that he preferred to be in bed for 12 months sick and not to have to do this. You know what that means? How many people are willing to come and say that they're willing to be in bed for 12 months and not to be over in Avera? You know what that is? 12 months in bed. Yeah?
What's the case? Huh?
Yeah, but 12 months of that.
What was the case? What was the other?
That he would have had to go with his money pouch and his staff to on Kippur. Yeah, we're always in the same thing. We didn't go anywhere. But Mechalel Kippur according to his Cheshbon, because according to Rabbi Gamliel was Kippur one day before. But again, but still, he had so much of a Yirat Chet that for him, since for him this is considered Kippur, for him he said he would have preferred to be sick for 12 months. Which one? If he would have been, yeah, say if he would have been Kippur according to his thing. Listen, there's a lot of things which are Chayav Karet. Right? Being with an Ida is Chayav Karet. Somebody goes with his girlfriend nowadays, that's Karet. That's not once. Every single time he lives with her. You understand? So that means, meaning Karet, you know, we think somebody is Mechalel Shabbat, it's Karet. Somebody, oh, big deal. What did he do already? He turned on the light. No, Karet. Saying Karet is not, a lot of people that think it has to be Kippur. Remember, Shabbat is more important than Kippur. Nida is Karet, just like Kippur. You understand? Being with a Goya, Karet. You understand? All these things. There's a lot of things which are mamash, like there's a, it's powerful stuff. It's not just stump. You know what I'm saying? So that's because people look at it that way. But not that because they not because they met that's what it is. No. I told you already. What do people find much more worse? Eating pig or eating bugs? You ask 99.999% of the people, they're gonna tell you eating pig. You're gonna tell them eating a pig, you didn't want to have it out. Eating
five each.
Exactly. So think about it. So what's more strange?
Eat the salad, then
exactly. Like, yeah. That's why a lot of people, they go, no. I don't eat out. I don't eat out. I only eat salads. I'm like, you know what? It was better to eat the pig. Mamash, because they don't realize it. And sometimes they think, well, what's a big deal? No, I don't eat out. I only eat salads.
That's a pig salad.
Then it's even worse. Yeah? Okay. So Amarlo, he comes and he says, right? Amarlo, Rebbe, tarsheni lomar lefanecha davar echad shelimatan. He says, can I come and tell you something that we already spoke about, that you taught me? Amalo, he says, Emor, say, Amalo, hare omer atem, atem, atem. It says three times to do with elehem wadai. It says three times over there, atem, the word atem. Mm-hmm. Atem afilu shogegin. Even if you're shogegin, you made a mistake and you made it Rosh Chodesh. Atem afilu mizidin, even if you purposely made it the wrong day. Or atem afilu mutin, even if you were caused to make a mistake. Whichever one. That means whether you made the mistake by accident, whether you made the mistake on purpose, or whether you were tricked to make the mistake, Balashon Azeh Amarlo, so he went and he says, it's still going to be a good Rosh Chodesh. So Balashon Azeh Amarlo, so he went and he told them, Akiva Nichamtani Nichamtani. You see that Akiva, Rabbi Akiva, was always the one that used to console people. He had this power of consolation. He had this power of mamash, you know, of keeping them calm, as they say. Okay? Fine. Next. Balo Etzel Bidosamen Ukanas. So he came by Rabbi Dosa ben Hurkanas. And it says over here like this, Tanu Rabbanan, we learned in a Braita. Lama lo nitparshu shemotam shel zekenim alalu? Why is it, right, that it wasn't explained the names of these zekenim? Shelo yomar adam, that a person shouldn't say ploni ke Moshe ve'aron. Right, that this person is like Moshe ve'aron. Ploni ke Nadav Avihu, ploni is like Nadav Avihu, ploni is like Eldad u'Medad. Ve'omer, and it says in Pasuk, ve'yomer Shemuel el ha'am, Hashem asa et Moshe ve'aron, ve'omer ve'yishlach et shem et yurba ve'gdam et yitzav ve'de Shemuel. Yerubal is Gidon. Why was he called Yerubal? Shasa merivah im Baal. He went and he made a merivah. He made a fight against the Baal. Bedan, who's Bedan? Shimshon. Why was he called Bedan? Tati midan, because he came from Shevedan. Yiftach is Yiftach, right? That's his real name. Kafi amudbet. The omen and it says Moshe ve'Aaron bechohana avu Shmuel bekorei shemo shakala katuv shlosha kaleolam kishlech moleolam. It called Shimshon, right? Yiftach and Gidon, right? And exactly like Shloshei Chamurei Olam, which is basically going to be whether it's Moshe Aaron and Shmuel. Lomar lecha Yerubal bedoro, Moshe bedoro, Bedan bedoro, Aaron bedoro, Yiftach bedoro, Shmuel bedoro. Lelamedcha, so it comes to teach you that even if you have kalch bekalim, but he became a parnasa mitzibur, hareu kabdi shaveirim. I mean, somebody's going to come and he's going to say, you know what? No, I don't respect him. Why? Because this rabbi, he's not like the previous rabbis that we used to have, or he's not. No. You have to remember that in that generation, that's who we have. Meaning, nobody could come up to the footsteps even of, you know, the Ben Ishchai, the Rav Chida, the Gaon Mivilna. But you have a rabbi. A rabbi is a rabbi. At the end of the day, in his generation, he's what there is. So therefore, if that's what there is in that generation, that's the greatest that there is. He's not a Moshe Rabbeinu, no. But he is the Moshe Rabbeinu in that generation. So that's what you have to pay attention to. The Omer, and it says in the Pasuk. ובאתה אל הכהנים הלווים ולשופט. Just like you're going to come to the כהנים הלווים, to the שופט, אשרי בימים ההם, אך יתעלה על דעתך שאדם הולך אצל הבן של יום ימיו, why you could go to a דיין that's not in your generation? האין לך ללכת אצל שופט בימיו, you only have to go to somebody that's in your generation, it's a בזוק. אל תאמר מה היה שהימים הראשונים טובים האלה. Don't say that the first days were better. Meaning, whatever psak that you have, that's what you have. Once upon a time, we had the Moshe Feinstein. Afterwards, now we have somebody else, which means that each generation, according to what it is, and that's it. Fine. Two dots. Natal Maklo Ma'oto Biado. He went and he took his makel and ma'ot. He took his money, right, and his money pouch in his hands. Tenor Rabbanan, he learned to write that. Kevin Shira Amad Nikison Shakol Rusho. So once he saw him, he got up and he kissed him, right, on his head. Amalo, he said, Shalom Lecha Rabbi B'Tamidi. Rabbi Shil Matani Torah B'Rabim. Right? You went and you taught Torah B'Rabim. Talmidi. Shani goes and lechazev to my talmid. He says, "No, what is the my talmid? You know why you're my student? Because I make a decree on you and you fulfill it. I mean, the fact that I went and I told you something and you fulfilled it, that's why." So Hashem Ador Shegadolim Nishvim Zarim. Fortunate is the generation that the Gidolim listen to the Ktanim. Yeah, Kalvachomer Ktanim the Gidolim. Kalvachomer that when the Ktanim are going to listen to the Gidolim, right? Kalvachomer Chiyuva. He says, "What is the Kalvachomer? It's an obligation." Saying obviously, if somebody's lighter, meaning somebody's less. Obviously, they have to listen to the bigger rabbis. Ela mitoch, obviously, he was calling Rabbi Yoshua Gadol, and he was a Katan kid. Ela mitoch shagdolim nishmen ktanim nosim ktanim kalvachomer says. If the gedolim listen to the ktanim, so kalvachomer the ktanim listen to the gedolim. Because if they saw that Rabbi Yoshua, that he's a Gadol Ador, is listening to Gamliel because he was the nasi, so he was the one in power. So then kalvachomer, any little guy is going to listen to Gamliel. Because if Rabbi Yoshua could listen to Gamliel, obviously them. Hadranach imenan imenan makirin. Okay, we just finished this perek and we're starting now the third chapter. Perek shelishi. Okay. Yeah. So he says not like this. Says the. Yeah. Hakadosh, we're starting the new perek. Perek shelishi. Ra'u betin lechol Yisrael. If right now the betin and the chol Yisrael were with them on the 31st of the month. Right? Or they didn't see it. They didn't speak Olam Kodash, but they didn't have enough time to say Mekudash. Ad shechashecha. Hareze meubar. Right? It becomes a Chodesh Maleh. Okay? And then the Rosh Chodesh Abba will be the first 30. Why? Because Betin cannot be Mekadesh. They could only be Mekadesh the Chodesh during the day, not during the night time. So since they didn't have enough time to say Mekudash, even though they all saw it, doesn't matter. Because it's not depending on the scene. It's depending upon the accepting the testimony and sanctifying it. You have to say Mekudash. If it wasn't Mekudash, it's not enough. Okay, so Ra'u Betin Milvad. What happens if the only Betin saw it? Meaning nobody else saw it, only the Betin. So Yamdu Shnaim, Yayidu Bifnehem, Yomru Mekudash Mekudash. So basically, two of the Dayanim that saw it, they're going to go in front of other Dayanim. And the other ones are going to say Mekudash Mekudash. Right? Well, no, because even if you're the biggest Dayan, you're not trusted. You have to testify in front of other Dayanim. Okay? Ra'u, even Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe Aaron, they're not trusted together. They're two brothers. There's a Psul and Edut. That's why they said that it's a Chok. It's not because of logic that two brothers are going to testify the same thing. Because even if you have Moshe and Aaron together, the second there's a kirva, right? The second there's a close proximity because of kinship, because of their family members, kaddish. Even if Moshe and Aaron, so, you doesn't know.
That's why companies
don't hire.
They count it as one.
Huh? They count it as one. Ra'uhu shlosha. Yeah, vehem bedin. So it says if right now you come and they saw three people, and they themselves are bedin. So two of them are going to come, and they're going to be put another two dayanim. They're going to testify in front of them. They're going to say, Mekudash, Mekudash. Because also the yachid can never say Mekudash. Meaning that even if you had three of a bedin, so two of the bedin are going to testify in front of the third one. Still, you can't. Why? Because one person cannot say Mekudash, Mekudash, Mekudash. It has to be a bedin saying Mekudash, Mekudash. So says the Gemara, right?
Is this where you get that you can get two people that aren't dayanim?
Yes, no. Oh, with certain circumstances. So says the Gemara like this: Lama li lemitna ra'u bedin v'chol yisrael. Why is it that in the Reisha, the former part of the Mishnah, we said that all bedin and all of Israel saw it? So says the Gemara: Itzich, we needed it. Salka, I mean, I would have thought to say choil v'ra'u bedin v'chol yisrael. Since the bedin and all of Israel saw it, ipar semala, right? It became mefursam. It became all. Meaning everybody knew about it. You don't even have to make it holy because everyone knows about it. Meaning that everyone knows. Mashmalan, if they didn't put the words Mekudash, Mekudash, it's not good. Everybody saw it though. Doesn't matter. They have to say it. They have to say it with their mouths, Mekudash, Mekudash. They come to Tanale. So since we learned, Ra'u Bedim V'chol Yisrael Nechseku Nechkeru Edim Lamali. So one second, but if everybody saw it, why do you have to do Chakirat Edim? Meaning, I understand that you have to investigate the witnesses if you didn't see it. So you want to make sure they're telling the truth. But everybody saw it. So you're right. You have to say the words mekudash, fine. But why do you have to do hakirat ha'edim? You saw it also with your own eyes.
You need witnesses.
So he says, inami nechkeru ha'edim velo ispiku lomar. No, you're right. In the case that everybody saw it, they don't need to be choker ha'edim. Choker ha'edim is just a reason to make sure they're telling the truth. If you already know they're telling the truth, you don't have to be choker, right? But rather, right? Velo ispiku lomar mekudash shechashecha zeh mubar. Vekem detanah ad shechashecha zeh mubar. So why do we have to talk about bichlal lechakirat ha'edim? So he says, it's I would have thought to say to have chakirat adim kitchilat adim, v'mekudash mekudash is like mardin. V'likad shebelayla, then you could do it because the halacha is if you start a bet din during the day, atchalat din is enough to start during the day. As long as you started during the day, you can finish a night. So if chakirat adim, meaning the investigating of the witnesses, is considered the beginning of the justice, beginning of the process, so I would have thought to say mekudash mekudash is the end. And as long as I started during the day, even if I finished during the night, then it's okay. Just like dinim emunot. Then I would learn the Mishnah. Dinim emunot danim b'yom. You start during the day, but you can finish during the night time. So hachinami, so to you, mekachim b'layla. Kamashpulam comes teaching on that the chakirat ha'edim is not considered the tchilat ha'din, and therefore, you have to say the words mekudash, mekudash before night time. And the second it became night time, kaddish, you have to wait for the next day. Even though you knew that it was already this day. You did it. You lost out. You lost out. You weren't on time,
but you only see the moon at night.
Doesn't matter. No, but it's always the night before. When are you? What's happening? You saw the moon the night before. You're coming during the day to the Bedin. They come so and they start doing Chakirat Ha'edim. Right now, if they didn't have enough, but you don't declare that day because you were too late. You missed out.
So when you saw the moon the night before, why is Rosh Chodesh?
The Eima Hachanami. So he says Eima Hachanami. Amarka. It says in a pasuk. When is it considered a chok? B'gmar din. Mishpat b'yom, just like mishpat always has to be done during the day. So it has to be done during the day. So you see from here that the chakirat ha'edim is not considered the chalat ha'din because the chok is only when you gmar, when you finish it off. So for since it has to be finished off during the day, you have to finish off during the day saying mekudash. Okay?
Before the night.
And therefore the chakirat ha'edim is not considered part of it. Fine, next two dots. Ra'u bedin, yamdu shnayim v'yadu b'fnim. So now, the bedin side, so two other people come, and then they're going to testify in front of those people. V'amai why? Lo te shmiya gdola m'riya. Shmiya is not any better than riya. Meaning, what's better? Seeing or listening?
Seeing
is always much better. So you have the bedin themselves that they saw it. Now you're going to need other people to testify in front of them, or they're going to testify in front of other people and saying that's again, the shmiya. That means basically seeing is always better than
they think that these edim have a dimayon.
No. So the dayanim have to come, and they themselves have to come. Right? So the question is, the question that we're asking is why is it that it's not enough that they themselves see it? If they are the ones that are doing everything, so they see it. They said they saw it during the nighttime. Now, if it's during the nighttime, we already said there's no kiddush hachodesh during the nighttime. It's only during the day. So when they want to come and be mekadesh hachodesh next day, there's no reiyah. So therefore, it's only testimony. Meaning like this, if they would have done it on the spot, then in Achanami, because then they're testifying according to the Re'iyah, meaning they're doing something according to the Re'iyah. It's only the next morning. The next morning when they come and they say it, that's testimony. It's not Re'iyah anymore, because they're not seeing it. Meaning if you're seeing something, you could say it. You don't need to testify about it. I don't have to testify that this Gemara, that Mordechai is here and he's got this Gemara. Right? I see Mordechai here and I see the Gemara. I don't need to testify in front of anybody. But let's say this afternoon, and now the Gemara is not here and Mordechai is not here. Now you have to testify. So same day. So the testimony is only for the next day because they can't do it at night. So the next day when they come to testify, now it's testimony. So therefore it's not Riyah anymore. So therefore that's why we're saying that we couldn't just come and take it according to that. Okay? So now it says, Ra'u shlosha bedvem bedin, yamdu shnayim yoshivu. Right? What? So it says the Gemara. He says, Ra'u shlosha bedvem bedin, yamdu shnayim yoshivu mechavrehem. So again, if three people saw it and they're bidding, so two will sit in front of the third and they're going to testify. Am I why? Why don't we just say the same thing? If you're going to tell me that they saw it in the nighttime, so then it's the exact same case. Which means again, if they saw during the daytime, so then again, we don't need to get into this. But then again, you have riyah. Riyah is greater than shemiya. Right? Seeing is better than hearing it. So that's it. You understand? That's why they always say gadol shimusha yotem limuda. Limud Torah is listening. when you see it and you are mishamesh tamidei chachamim and you see how the rabbis act, you learn from seeing. Seeing is better than listening. Right? That's why they always say practice what you preach. Why? Because your children, they learn more from what you do than what you say. You could say a lot of things. The question is, what do you do? Because they're learning from that. So it says, what is a seifa? The ena yachid me'eman al yedei atzmo. The yachid is not going to be believed on himself. The second, I mean, was I would have thought to say, hol v'tanya dinei mamonot, right, b'shlosha, that you always need three for dinei mamonot. V'im haya mumche l'rabim, but if he's an expert, so then he could do it even by himself, then afilu b'yachid. Hachanam nikat shabi yachid, so also one person should be enough. You should be kiddush ha-chodesh. Hamashmananda, we don't say that. V'im hachanam, so suddenly, why not? En l'cha mumche l'rabim b'yisrael yotem Moshe Rabbeinu, there's no mumche greater than Moshe Rabbeinu. And it says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu told him, Adi karon ba'adach, that until you have Aaron with you, sorry. Thank you. So when it says lachem, it's together. And it's talking about Moshe and Aaron. So says Gemara, lemeimra de edna said dayan, right? Are you going to tell me now, the 1 second, are you going to tell me now that ed becomes an adayan? I mean, basically, what are you trying to say? That somebody that should be an ed kasher, now he's a dayan to see it? Right? Why? Because if the entire betin saw it, and now he's acting as a dayan and not an ed, he's like, no, yeah, he's got an interest. He's like biased because he also saw it. Right. So Lema Matnitin is not like Rabbi Akiva. The Tanya we learned it right. Sanhedrin Sharu Echad Sharagazim. Like the case that I told you before. What happens if you have a Sanhedrin that they saw, all the Sanhedrin saw somebody kill. Now they have to judge, right? Says the, we're going until the Mishnah, right? Kavava Mudal, 26a1. By Miksatan Nasu Edim, so part of them become the Edim. Umisatan Nasu Dayanim, and the rest of them they become Dayanim, right? These are the words of Rabbi Tarfon. So Rabbi Tarfon says, they're going to testify, right? But what's going to happen? Part of them are going to be dayanim, part of them are going to be edim. Part of dayanim, part of edim. Now, this is so obviously saying, right? No. But here you see that even though they're biased because they also saw it, but you see, ed na sedayan means an ed. That means somebody that you could be, right? Presumably, you could be the witness. You're allowed to be also the judge, which means that we already know what you're going to judge. Rabbi Akiva says, no, at the same time. That's what we're saying.
No, you're saying that some of them.
Yeah. Some Rabbi Tarfon comes and he says,
as both.
Kulam na'asim edim. All of them are edim. Right? Why? Because all of them are testifying. Then ed na'ase dayan. Since everybody could be edim, an ed cannot be a dayan. So according to Rabbi Kiva, they need somebody else. They have to get a new betin. They have to get like a new Sanhedrin. So afilu timer, it says, no. Afilu timer Rabbi Kiva, even you could say this Rabbi Kiva. Ad kalon kamar Rabbi Kiva. When does Rabbi Kiva say that? Meaning to do with life and death situation. That's the only time that we say that. The Rahman Amar Bezaturah says, "V'shafetu eda v'tzilu edana." We wanted to save the person from death. They came the chaziu. So since they saw, they can't see it. Meaning, if the entire Sanhedrin saw that he killed, they can never find. They saw physically with their eyes, so they cannot find a route to save the guy. It's impossible. They saw it with their own eyes. So since they saw with their own eyes, Kaddish, there's nothing to talk about. So that's why there was a special deen by Dinei Nefeshot. They cannot do that. However, though, Bar Hacha, Rabbi Akiva's Modeh, then an Ed could be a Dayan, because it's not Nefeshot. Meaning, if it's knowing the truth, you don't. An Ed could be a Dayan, even though you're biased, because you already saw it, because you already know what's going to happen. They do it as a tekets. How do you say the tekets? It's like the stage. You know, they do it like as a show, the ceremony. Right? But technically speaking, you already know what's going to happen. But by Dinei Nefeshot, it's special, because obviously we don't want to... You know, we want to save him, and this is impossible going to be to save. So we continue with the Hashem tomorrow with the Mishnah.